When the opportunity came up to direct a project for Have You Ever Seen the Rain, I knew that we needed to do something really special, something that connected younger generations with older generations, something that was universal, something that everyone could relate to. So I got my headphones on and I played the song on repeat. I just felt this bevy of emotions. I felt nostalgia, friendship, melancholy, but at the same time it was this weird feeling of adrenaline and freedom, and I was on this rush of energy that I don't really feel often.
Should we have them drive to the side of us and get some of that stuff?
And get next to you guys so we do a tracking shot of you.
Sure.
Okay, so we're gonna coordinate that.
We're gonna switch spots. And action both cars. Music is playing, and the music's going, yeah.
We needed to find actors that cared about the music, a creative team behind the camera, to try and make this little time capsule that represented what the song means to us now.
That Dahl is following us.
Oh, thank you.
What?
Okay, bear with me.
My character's name is Evan, and he's a sweet guy who works out of his family's farm, and he has two best friends, Alice and Julia, and Julia is about to move away. You know, he's had a crush on Julia for probably most of his life, and he's thinking maybe I should make a move before she goes away, but, you know, he doesn't want to ruin friendship. What's going on? You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure? You all nervous about tomorrow or something?
Me nervous? Your eyes were just glistening.
They were glistening?
They were glistening.
We're gonna miss you. A lot. I think all of CCR's music has a certain timeless quality to it, and it's that ineffable quality you can't really describe, but for some reason whenever you put the song on, everybody smiles. It's completely timeless. I don't know why it's timeless, but it just is. It's just freaking good.
One of the only reasons why we got to go to Montana in the first place is because our producer, Luke, grew up there.
I grew up on a farm in Montana, outside of Bozeman, Montana, and as Laurence and I wrote this, the story comes from my real life of how you just hang out in the country. These moments we captured aren't unlike the reality. In a lot of ways, that landscape and that feeling of openness and freedom out there.
So I'm playing Julia, and the narrative is about three friends and the push and pull of what it means to love someone and to grow, and how you grow together, and how growing together is not as simple as corn, beans, and squash.
We need a train to come by.
The train.
Have you ever seen the train? I feel like everyone, if not a specific memory, has a sense memory of the kind of melancholy joy that the song, even if you didn't speak English, you would know what the song feels like. It's not like any other project I've ever done. And it's been such a community. Every place that we're shooting has a backstory, and it feels really nice. Everything that we're doing just is fast friends, fast family.
For me, the song means soaking up those moments with the people we really love. When you're young and you're with your best friends, you're just in the moment. Like, nothing matters other than spending time with them and enjoying yourself. I feel like Alice kind of symbolizes that point that everyone goes through. You're getting to the age where you start to maybe think, have the choices and opinions I've developed been my own versus my family? And I think maybe also Julia moving away catalyzes that a little bit, departing from that world. Jack, Sasha, and I all grew up in such different environments, polar opposites, each of us. And so we showed up to this beautiful house and this beautiful farm. And it was really cool because we mentally start to develop the idea of growing up in an environment like that, that was so unlike ours. It's just been a blast because the chemistry and dynamic between us is lots of fun, and to like dance in the car and watch the beautiful sunset and just hang out with a bunch of people who love Creedence Clearwater Revival.
The most gratifying part about directing anything is that you get to work with people who are smarter than you. You get to work with people who are elevating your idea into something way bigger and better than you ever thought it could be.
As a cinematographer shooting a piece out in the middle of Montana, one of the things that excited me was that it wasn't a performance video, it was a chance to really illustrate the feeling behind the song. To do that would be to set some ground rules. We decided that the camera should feel like a friend, another friend that was experiencing that night with the three actors. The camera would be mostly handheld, that it wouldn't be sort of magically flying over the landscape in a drone. We'd keep it really intimate, we'd keep it really evocative, and always tuned into sort of the emotional key of that beat. And we only had a few days in Montana, so Laurence and I spent a lot of time breaking the song down and isolating sort of exactly what we needed to create a compelling story that takes place without any dialogue, that rides on the backbone of the song and the beats of the song.
You know that only one light works, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's okay. It gives it some character.
It definitely gives it character, yes.
I think we really leaned into a sense of filming it through the eyes of a Montana native. That intimate relationship with those dirt roads, the landscapes, the dive bars, the neon lights. We weren't trying to show a picture postcard version of the landscape. We were trying to show how it looks to somebody who's grown up in these fields, for whom this is all they've known, and now they're going to a new step in their life. And I think all that really evokes that sense of belonging, of home, of leaving something immensely familiar behind.
Based on what I was told about each individual character's personality and their overall sense of being, I was able to create an entire look for that character. Alice's character was very conservative, comes from a nice family, so I put her in a great jacket and some light blue jeans. Julia's look was more rebellious, independent. We found a perfect outfit that really represented her character with ripped blue jeans and some tall boots. Evan, he was pretty simple in a Levi jacket, some jeans and some nice boots, and it was just your classic all-American guy.
When you're making an indie project like this one, a lot of times you need luck. And from beginning to end, we just got really lucky. We shot in late October, and a week before we were filming, it was snowing, and then somehow it was sunny, and it was in the 50s and 60s. We met amazing locals who just became friends of ours. They really believed in the project, and they believed in us. And those are the sort of breaks that you need to make something that reflects what you're thinking.
The song is something that is so timeless and brings everyone so much joy. Every time I mentioned this to anyone, everybody had a smile on their face.
I've just always been a huge fan of this song. The song is the perfect length. It's like exactly what you want a song to be. You want more of it. You don't want it to end so soon, but you can play it on a loop and no one would complain.
I think the beauty of music is that it cuts through cultural language and almost any barrier that keeps us apart. It really brings us together. I heard CCR as a young boy in India, you know, thousands of miles away from the Bay Area where the band grew up. But I feel a very emotional and intimate connection to the music.
It's a song that literally spans generations of Americans and people around the world. And to me, it's very much the soundtrack of growing up out there.
Have You Ever Seen the Rain makes me think of my childhood. It makes me think of heartbreak. Life is hard. Life is beautiful. Life is really confusing and complicated sometimes. I wanted to tell a story that reminded us of those things. To live life to the fullest and not be afraid and embrace whatever you're feeling. I'm just so happy that we got to make this. Oh, hey guys. Oh, that's a wrap.
Yeah!